Hello, fellow Cravers, and welcome to the CTG Podcast for Monday, the 21st of September. Yes, it's a Monday. It's weird. We usually do this on Wednesday. The reason why we're doing this on Monday instead of Wednesday, though, this week is because, well, I'm not here on Wednesday. I'm going to be going to EGX. Yay! I'm going to play with some VR headsets and bits and pieces.
Good for you.
As always, you have me. I am joined by Elijah Woods, Billy, and Shimmy.
Hi, Shimmy. Why don't you say hello?
Good for you, Shimmy. No, it's just an image. And unfortunately, Cajr's camera's not working tonight, so...
I blame Skype. I'm a hobbit.
He's a hobbit. So, how has your how's your weekend been, by the way?
Short.
Very short.
Yeah, it feels short in there.
I think it's because, like I said, we're doing this on a Monday. This is really unusual for us.
Well, it's not only that. It's not only that. The fact our weekends are going to be the same length of whether we do podcast Monday, Wednesday, or Friday.
Yeah, but it's still going to be short. Yeah, but it would still feel short because we usually have at least another couple of days before we even do this.
It's going to feel long next
time. My reference of short was nothing to do with the podcast. My reference of being a short weekend is it went too fast.
Yeah, it went fast for you. It didn't go fast for me.
Whose fault's that?
A certain person that we don't mention on the podcast. Yeah. So I think we should move straight on to talking about games, and I think we should start with talking about Konami. They've sunk themselves now, haven't they? Now that they've officially announced...
They've been doing that for the past year, haven't they?
The funny thing is, when this report came out about them saying that they're not going to be doing any more AAA games apart from Pro Evo, I swear we already knew about this.
Yeah,
you could pretty much guess it was going to be Pro Evo was going to be their only...
But it's alright, they announced the Silent Hill game, didn't they? The Silent Hill pinball, like, Sleep Machine, was it? That's enough, right?
If that's what you want, if that's what makes you happy.
You don't.
Yeah, that's what I want in my Silent Hill games, Fruit Machines.
Nothing better. You can only see half the pinball machine because the rest of it is covered in fog.
Cool, well, I've got three knives. Ow.
But the thing is, we knew this, like I said, we knew this was going to happen. It was just a matter of time since...
I didn't expect it to be so soon.
I think Metal Gear was the last big release after Pro Evo as well that's come out this week. Mm. So it's like, with nothing in the pipeline now, might as well do it now. Get it out of the way.
Yeah, but I do find it funny, especially this year, they have been the most talked about with
people. Not all for all the good reasons,
but at the start of this year, they had so many good things happening for them. A lot of people were excited about Metal Gear Solid 5 coming out this year. They were also... The PT demo was a huge hit that... A lot of people got confused thinking it was actually still a game, not a demo, or a trailer, sorry, for Silent Hills. And then it just went downhill
very fast.
It's very frustrating because obviously they know how to make a good game.
Hey, what's it? I know.
So, I mean, they know what we want and they can deliver it if they, you know, put the heart and soul into it. It's not like... You know, Sega these days, where they just seem to shovel disappointment after disappointment in software. They actually do, you know, like Metal Gear Solid 5, from what I ain't played it myself, from what I've
brilliant
seen,
game.
A success. So,
I haven't played
PT, obviously, got a lot of people hyped up, and everyone enjoyed a playable trailer. It's not every day that people would, like, you know, like go that mad about a playable trailer to the point where it's like watched on YouTube.
The thing is, I think this is the first time that I've ever seen something like this happen. If you go onto YouTube and search for PT, if Konami still allows videos
up... All the top, you know...
Well, yeah, everyone was doing a PT demo, apart from us, of course. But they was doing, like, a Let's Watch of someone playing PT. everyone was doing it. It was a huge hit. And I don't know. I don't know what was going through their minds when they decided, you know what? No, we're not doing this anymore.
This is good. We don't do good. Let's get rid of this.
I think the root of it, I think the whole Hideo Kojima fallout with Konami, that's kind of been the main reason why, I think. I think it's like, well, it's Metal Gear is our only other decent game. Hideo Kojima's going into Silent Hills.
Are they the guys who are behind Just Dance? Is it Just Dance or Dance Central? One of those two. They've got a dancing game, haven't they?
It weren't Just Dance, because that's Ubisoft, isn't it?
Yeah, that's Ubisoft.
I swear they had a dancing game as well.
Silent Hill Dancing.
Oh my god, that's the next title!
But it's yeah, I think the whole Hideo... I think Hideo Kojima was basically every big project they had on console left, apart from PES, was Hideo Kojima was involved in.
Yeah.
Because he was involved in Silent Hills, wasn't he? And,
no offense, but when it came to things with Konami, how do you know any other director there, to be honest, apart from Hideo Kojima?
Maybe it were a case of... I mean, we don't know the inside story. We don't know what's gone on behind the scene.
Well, but there's been many stories about it.
But maybe it's a case of the higher-ups at Konami decided that Hideo Kojima had too much power at the company, and then they tried... It's like a internal power struggle, basically, the root cause of it.
Yeah, but no offence, there's having too much power and then completely nosediving off the deep end.
Yeah, yeah, but maybe this was the only way they thought of saving the company away from the
Kojima's demands were just too high for what Konami could afford. And if he goes, then his whole team goes, and therefore they had to just make a complete halt in all their development because their team's gone.
Yeah, well, there was rumours...
That's my theory.
There's also been reports that the guy who made the Fox engine has now left Konami as well. So, I don't know. It's sad because I think everyone's played at least one Konami game nowadays. More than likely, it'll be a Metal Gear Solid game, but...
Nope. Well,
or a Silent Hill game.
Castlevania and Silent Hill for me.
Exactly. So I think this is the end of... I would say they are a huge name in our industry. Everyone knows Konami in gaming. I think we are starting to see the end of Konami, unfortunately. Okay, like you could say, oh, they've got Pro Evo. Yeah, you can't just live with just Pro Evo. No offense, it's
the silver medal to FIFA, like exactly. For football.
I don't know. I've played FIFA 16. It's not any better.
So I mean, it's the game for when FIFA fucks up. Like, oh, that's, you know, this version of FIFA shit. Let's guess we play PES this time.
I have to say though, having played Phantom Pain a bit, and not Metal Gear Solid, that is, I'm actually glad if that's going to be the last one that they've ended it like that. It is such a good game, and I've not even scratched the surface of it yet.
Yeah, but would you want to see the Silent Hills game coming out, at least?
I'm not a big fan of Silent Hills, so I can't really say.
The thing is about Silent Hill, the series, is that obviously everyone remembers the first three being fantastic, and then I think four was okay, but then after that it's just had a nosedive. Mm. Like, it's sort of like Resident Evil these days as well. It's kind of drawn parallel where it's like they've got their focus has gone towards other attentions that are not...
Well, look what we talked about last week about what was the game again.
So, and from what you see, it looks like it's going right back to, you know, its roots of like the actual horror. And so everyone got really excited for me, myself included, and then suddenly it gets canned.
But to be honest, I don't see them staying away from AAA titles. They'll probably say, yeah, we're not going to be going to AAA titles. Or is it more about a game they're going into more?
No, I've heard that they're going to be focusing more on, you know, like the machines in arcades and stuff like that.
Yeah, but like I say, it'll get to a stage where they'll think, you know, it'll just be a case of, you know what, let's just throw out, say, another Metal Gear Solid game. Let's just throw it out, see what happens, see what the response is. And if they'll get to that stage eventually. They'll get to the stage, you know what, let's see if we can make some money off the Metal Gear Solid name. or the Silent Hill name, or whatever name they've got.
Metal Gear Solid slot machine, yay!
But yeah, I can't see them personally, after being in console game making games for so long, them completely coming away from it. I know they're keeping pairs, but I think they'll come back to it. Maybe it may take a few years, but I think they will eventually come back and say, you know, we're going to make, and it'll be like, right, you know what, we're going to make a brand new game. It's going to be this.
So how long do you think it's going to take until you see Hideo Kojima on Kickstarter?
I think he's
for a Metal Gear Solid-like game.
I don't think he'll need to go to Kickstarter.
I think
another studio will take a chance on him.
Yeah.
Because of what he's done.
Someone will produce his work easily. He won't need Kickstarter.
He's somebody who doesn't need Kickstarter.
So who would you like to see Hideo Kojima go to? If anything, what would you like to see him working on next?
Well, still third party title, so. So, you know, either. What? Oh, I nearly said Ubisoft and EA.
No, don't go to EA. Yeah, he's going to be working on the next FIFA game.
I know, I was really disgusting now. Bethesda.
What about giving Hideo Kojima the Call of Duty franchise?
It could work. That's the thing about
it could make it into a more of a stealthy game, like basically a rip off of Metal Gear Solid, but with Call of Duty aspects.
If he gets a chance to have try and make a rip-off of Metal Gear Solid, I know he will try and make it.
Well, if he's popular and if he's wanted, it's like you're getting these, on Kickstarter, you get these spiritual successors to. It's like,
well, I don't think he should make a spiritual successor. I think he should just make a complete new game, like...
Shift Liquid.
Or what about the Gears franchise?
Yeah, the thing is, I think that's what I would expect to see him going towards. The more gritty games. I don't see him going to, like, Square Enix and go on a Final Fantasy fun.
No. I think... Or, this one, what about GTA?
I don't think GTA needs him.
I don't think he needs him.
I'm just looking at my games at the moment. I'm just looking at them. Maybe be interested.
So, anyway...
A bat, Shanik the Hedgehog.
Yeah, well, like I say, I think...
It can't get any worse, can it?
I don't know, you could give him Mario.
It's a meme! What the hell is happening?
Why who left this box here?
Ding!
I'm going to stomp on it.
Is it a stealthy Mario game where he's got to slowly infiltrate Bowser's castle?
Mario! Every time you die.
Yeah, like I said, there's lots of... He won't go to Kickstarter, and that's the top and bottom of it. Kojima does not need Kickstarter.
Fair enough. Well, like I said, hopefully we'll see something with Hideo Kojima in the future. Maybe even something in VR, probably. Doubt it. But we'll see what happens with him in 10. Let's talk about... When we mentioning something before the podcast, it was...
Don't ask me how true is trying to sort me the thing
Twitch
out.
Plays.
Oh, the Twitch Plays stuff, yes.
Yeah. Oh, that's going to fall flat.
So, currently, what I've been told is... Twitch has now conquered Pokemon. I think they either conquered or gave up on Dark Souls. More than likely gave up on Dark Souls.
Yeah.
And now they've moved their focus into Fallout 3. And what I've been told about it so far, are they still in the vault?
I bet they are. I'm probably still talking to Butch, right?
There's no way in hell that game is going to...
I think it's an accomplishment when they get out of the vault, and I think that's about it,
but,
really.
How are they going to fight? That's the problem.
It's going to take them, like, a week to get to Megaton.
The thing is,
it's going to take them a week just to. Have they passed the test yet? Done the test?
Yeah, they've passed the test. They're like in the escape to the vault area. I don't know how they passed the test. Maybe they skipped it.
I'd like to say, I have not seen it, so.
Me neither, but I'm just thinking of Fallout. What happens in early Fallout 3?
They work perfectly for Pokemon. It works for games like that where you can actually take your time with them. Fallout, you can't really do that.
Yeah.
You're taking one step at a time. One step at a time. And then Dog Meat's died again. Oh, God.
I mean, another problem is, what happens if you've got something that it's on a timer?
You're screwed.
I don't think there's many instances in Fallout 3 of a timer.
I'm not sure.
Like radiation, I think that might be in trouble if you're going to a radiated area and you're just all standing there for a bit, like.
Yeah, that's
what's
not
this glowy sensation?
No, I'm starting to worry if they get into a conversation with someone, and how long will they be on that conversation for, going up and down on the options?
Let me put it this way: it won't be good entertainment.
No,
it'll be one of those you keep popping back to it. And it's they just got further down that corridor I saw them in yesterday.
That's what I used to do. I used to, like, when I watch Pokemon, Twitch plays Pokemon, I'd see what they're up to and go, all right, I'm going to go to bed now. I wake up in the morning and go, okay, let's see what they're up to now, and they're in the exact same spot as I was before I went to bed.
Yeah, but I think they can't really live up to the magic what they did with the first Twitch plays Pokemon.
I don't think it's got the crowd either.
Oh, God, how much weird stuff came up from that. Didn't they worship a Helix? Oh, yeah. Praise the Helix.
The Helix fossil, weren't it?
Yeah.
And wanted, was it a Vulpix or something? The evil.
You got Bird Jesus, which was the Pidgeot that just carried them throughout the whole game.
Oh my God! This is where Twitch has gotten to. I'm going to be pointing it out.
At least it's doing something unique.
It's doing something unique. I give them the dues.
It got to the point where it became mainstream media. I remember watching it on TV, like they talked about it, and I was like, no way. I just watched this last night. I didn't think it was worth it being on the news. It must have been a slow news day.
So, we've said, they've done Pokemon, they've done Dark Souls, they've done Fallout. What would you like to see them Twitch play next?
FIFA. That would be an accomplishment and a half.
Resident Evil.
That would be an accomplishment.
First zombie. You're done.
I'm looking at the title. That's it, it's over. In front of me. What about WWE?
just
send them a little match.
Yeah, fighting game's perfect, I think.
Yeah, do it to. Oh, that'd be perfect.
Any fighting game, because you could just have it like you've. You know, I think they did. Yeah. I think a few have done that before, because I remember like you can control both characters and just see who wins, like place bets and stuff.
Paul House asked, "What are you guys expecting from TwitchCon?"
TwitchCon.
Yeah. Not much, to be honest. I think it's not going to be as successful as they're hoping it to be. But then again, I think this is its first year, isn't it?
Don't ask me on this. I don't follow it much, I'm afraid.
I think it's going to... They are going to get the crowd in. But it does seem that it keeps popping up on Twitch. Saying, oh, there's still tickets there. Come on. We're on an island. Help us.
We own an island.
I think the problem with TwitchCon, it's not focused. It's too random. Because it's like people streaming video games. They could be streaming absolutely anything. Now, I expect them to be doing special events, like maybe some speedrunning things and stuff like that. Maybe a tournament or two. Yeah. But I don't expect anything huge.
Yeah, oh, sorry. The thing is, like I said, it's its first year, so I do not expect much. I've heard of worse conventions. I think there was one Dash Con, which had a ball pit. Yeah, and that's it. That was its main attraction. If you had a ticket, you could play in the ball pit for 10 minutes.
Yay!
But I don't expect much from it. No offense to people on Twitter.
Swear.
With things like YouTube, but when there's like conventions for YouTube, there's loads of conventions for YouTube. YouTubers, sorry. You gotta think it this way. YouTube's been now around 12 years. It's been around for quite a while. Twitch has just suddenly popped up in a lot of people's views, and there's been a huge wave of new people streaming thanks to consoles
Twitch,
and
it's
PC.
Only just like in recent years become mainstream.
So it is quite, it's still too new for me to say that it, I don't think it needs a convention yet.
Well, obviously you've got loads of like famous Twitch streamers, don't you? So obviously, if you're like a fan of many, you know, sometimes it only takes just one Twitch, you know, streamer to make you want to go to a convention, doesn't it?
But then again, it could just be what generation we're in. I'm more a fan of I'm more a fan of YouTubers than Twitch streamers, to be honest. I find more entertaining watching them. But then, it's like us. We're not just streamers. We're YouTubers as well. Our footage goes on both. We're both areas. This is a good point. What would you count yourselves as? Would you count yourselves more of a YouTuber or of a streamer? I count myself more as a YouTuber.
Well, I guess I've only like streamed like a couple of times, and I've like got I've quite a few more videos, so I'd say I'm probably more of a YouTuber. But obviously I've been in the podcast for a bit now, so that's
streamer.
You're saying you're more of a streamer?
Yeah, because I don't do anything for YouTube, do I? For me.
What, like the Until Dawn?
That was not originally going to be on YouTube.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, but like I said, all our footage is first streamed on Twitch, but then it goes on to YouTube. But I still count myself more as a YouTuber. I think there's a bit bigger market there for them.
But I have to say this: don't you stream things just for sake of streaming things, and then you sometimes think after, you know what, this could be a bit good for YouTube, and then you decide.
I agree.
Isn't your first thought, you know what, this is going to be like a random night, I'll stream it, and it's like, oh, that turned out to be a good night, I'll put it on YouTube.
What's it says, she's definitely a streamer. I have stuff auto go onto my YouTube, however, I'm a Twitcher.
you need to get that looked at, what's it?
Yeah. Well, I think it depends on what the video is. I have moments where there's a video where I'm thinking, oh, this is for YouTube. Like, for example, the podcast.
But then there is
sometimes where I think, I'm just going to stream this and see how it goes. Well, usually when I'm streaming stuff, it's the newest stuff that I'm not 100% sure if it's going to be successful. There's certain games that I will, certain things I'll do streaming but for YouTube, and then there's certain things where I'll just stream but then it'll end up on YouTube. But it's weird. I still count myself more as a YouTuber over streamer. No, I think it's just there's more notability of being a YouTuber over a streamer at the moment.
But YouTube's been along that. Like I said earlier, YouTube's been around so much longer.
Exactly. That's my thought of it.
I think Twitch is more for the here and now. Like, oh, I'm Twitching, watch me live. And then YouTube is like the archive sort of thing.
Yeah.
Like, oh, look what we did in the past. Now,
I think it's just down to your taste, really. It's just how you want to do your stuff, really. Because, like, some people like find it easy just to make the YouTube videos instead of like doing it live. Not a lot of people, like some people like to do post commentary on their like let's plays in games and stuff like that, and not do it live at all, like not even live
they
commentary.
That's a good point. There's people who just record it and then just put it up onto YouTube.
We're
a different kind we're a different kind in my opinion, so we need our own category. We do both. We're like a hybrid. We're streamers, but we're also YouTubers.
We want our own little section.
You're Twitching YouTubers.
We're Twitching YouTubers.
Twitching YouTubers.
So what if you just stream on YouTube gaming?
Twitch tube.
You're Twitch tube. If you see, okay. Let's move on to the next subject. Like someone was mentioning about WWE 2K16 in the chat. Well, there was some news that popped up this weekend, which is really going to annoy me and Cadge.
Yes, the lack of a...
certain divas, yeah.
Yes.
By the sounds of things, that Charlotte, who is now...
Divas champion. If you haven't seen Nights Champions last night,
I'm sorry. we've also got Sasha Banks,
Bailey, and Becky Lynch.
So the four horsewomen.
What did you just say? The fourth horsewoman. The fourth horse.
But yeah, they said that they're not going to be in the game and they're not going to be DLC, which is a stupid move in my opinion.
Yeah, Jimmy, turn your camera on.
Unfortunately, Cajr can't, and the other one's not moving.
The other one is just a picture of somebody who's streaming.
That's another member of the Cravers Your Game who's not here at the moment. We thought we'd just put that picture there for the hell of it. But Cajr, what are your thoughts on this?
It's stupid of them, but what can you do? You can't.
I don't understand why they're not doing this. Like, this whole Divas Revolution, and then they're not doing this. I can't.
It's one of those. It's like in the last game, you could say, why can't we have this person come in? Even if it's a DLC, obviously DLC fucked the game up online.
Oh, God, yeah.
But, you know, you could have said, well, I want this person. You'll never please everybody. Now, for reasons unknown, they've added certain people, like from the Astrid and all that, but then they've failed to follow through on this whole Divas Revolution storyline by not putting them in.
Yeah, well, when does the game come out? It comes out...
October the 27th.
So, something might happen in Hell in the Cell, which is at the end of October as well, where this whole Divas Revolution thing might be thrown out the window. So, I don't know. There must be reasons behind it. Crazy reasons, but there must be reasons behind why they're not there. And hopefully it will not screw up our predictions. Well, then likely it will. Again. How would you feel if it screws up our predictions on the first time we use it?
Pissed off, but I think there's less chance of that this time. Because I think they've said the creator Divas coming in. So even if you can't get them officially, you can always download them.
Well, I hope Creative Divas, because that is the one thing that really annoyed me with...
I would think, especially with what's been happening recently, they would have more than just two Divas in a single match.
Yes, hopefully.
It wouldn't be hard.
Well, all we can do is wait and see what happens with that. Like you said, October the 27th is when it comes out, and it's coming out on the PS3, PS4, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. Why is it coming back on the PS3 and the Xbox 360? Are we still bringing games out for that?
Yep.
Apparently so. There's people still playing it, GD, and it'll be like a light version. There'll be some things missing. I think last year it didn't have the career mode.
Yeah, they actually had to hold it back for the Xbox One and the PS4 because of the whole CM Punk thing. CM Punk was supposed to be a big part in the career mode thing, and then the whole trouble he had with the WWE. So that's WWE thing for you.
I'm not talking that much because.
Yeah, you're not a huge fan.
Because I know nothing about wrestling, so I'm just going to smile and nod.
Do you want to talk a little VR news that we got? So we know now that Project Morpheus is called the PlayStation VR, don't we?
Boring.
What a boring name. Unfortunately, I'm not going to have a go of it because I missed out registering to have a go of it. Yeah, if you're going to EGX, you had to register to have a go of the PlayStation VR. I think it's the same with the Vive as well. But news is that Dead or Alive Extreme 3 launches spring 2016. Now, this is Japan-only game at the moment.
Is Extreme the one where you're just basically pairing on all the women?
Yes.
The game?
Yes, it is.
So, GD's going to be getting that imported.
And it's also got PlayStation VR support.
Oh, no. You Japanese, you dirty little bastards. Dirty bastards. GD's going to be moving over there soon.
We ordered it now.
Well done, Billy. Yeah, so unfortunately, this game is still not coming out in the it's only going to be coming out for Japan and Asia, unfortunately.
Import.
Even if import, I don't see the point. And they've said that it's going to have the PlayStation VR support, but they haven't told us what it's going to be doing in the game. So my question here is,
what do you think
the VR support will be used for Dead or Alive Extreme 3 of the menus? The menus.
Yeah, for menus, it'd be nice. You know, yeah. Just navigate the menu by going.
Yeah.
You'll probably turn your head and it'll probably be like a tile system.
What if it's just used for the volleyball? What if there is no pervity thing for it? It's just there.
Well, it's so your hand's free.
Well, one of the things that I could see it being used for, and GD is probably going to be the one doing this, it's going to be, you're going to have one of the women in front of you, you'll be about chest height, and you go,
and then your head butt the desk.
No offense, but I remember a long time ago where we had Team Ninja who said, we're trying to be a little bit more serious. We're trying to be more serious with our games like Dead or Alive. We want to see it as a true fighting game. And here is Extreme 3 with VR support.
It's just going to fall flat. Reason for it.
It's not going to fall flat. A lot of people end up getting it.
Well, some things won't be flat. We know that, but... VR support, it's very new. Everything's going to try and use it in some way, shape, or form. But I just can't see it work so at the moment. I just can't see... The only games I can see it working for are the horror genre, where you're fully immersed in it.
Yeah.
Well,
It's hard to think of any, like, playing a game without a controller, really, because it is such a... intuitive way to play in a game, really. Buttons, it's quick. Yeah, it takes a split second to make reactions and stuff like that. But when you're using like VR headsets and stuff like that, your reaction times and stuff like that.
Yeah, and also for certain games, you might get too immersed in it. So say, for example, it applies it to a football game, and you're say sat there and you're playing, and you kick, and somebody just happens to be walking past you at the time you kick. Or there's a table, or something very heavy next to where your foot is. There's going to be incidents like that.
There is going to be incidents.
Well, we all remember them days, don't we, when the Wii first come out and everyone started throwing their Wii remotes at their flat-screen TVs and smashing them.
Yeah, but then, like you said, all technology has had its problems. Like you said with the Wii, where you was basically throwing it through your TVs. The Kinect had its big problem as well, where
it didn't really
tell you that you needed a big room.
Yeah.
And then they thought, don't worry, everybody's got a big room. Yeah, in America they do, not everywhere else.
I think the fact they were almost showing in living rooms when they were originally showing the Kinect, it was in a family living room, not in a child's bedroom.
Even in someone's living room, it still wouldn't fit properly.
Depends how big your living room is. My living room is quite big, it would fit mine.
Yeah, but...
Because I don't know if we have bigger houses than you, clearly.
Yeah, and they wonder why they're not selling so well in Japan.
Oh, yeah, they're like little cubes, aren't they?
I don't know. It's one of those things where, like you said, all technology has had its problems. I think even Nintendo 3DS, when the first one came out, then you had to be right in front of it, didn't you, for the 3DS thing to work? And I think a lot of people ended up turning the 3D part off of it.
Yeah, I do.
Didn't,
It's the gimmick part of the console. No one buys it for the 3D effect. They buy it for the games. It's another Nintendo's hit and miss with the gimmick again.
I don't know. The new one seems to work a lot better because it does actually track your...
Even then, I'll probably have it still turned off because I find it distracting.
Did a lot of people not find it give them headaches as well? I never had that experience.
You're getting in the way of me playing the game. I found it annoying. It put me off.
I think there was also an age rating on the actual 3D as well for a handheld which is aimed for kids. And it said, no, the 3D, you've got to be a certain age because of it can give you
headaches. Only saying like 3 plus or something.
For health reasons, you know. No. It was quite old. I think it was about 7, 8, 9, that kind of age, where they said, no, don't let them play.
I know when the 3DS first come out, everyone was all panicking and started saying that the 3DS could make you go blind and stuff like that. Like, it got over-dramatized, so maybe it was the result of that.
Many things can make you go blind.
Well, it's the same sort of
strategy. He's not blind.
I'm already wearing glasses.
Because too plays Dead or Alive Extreme too much.
It was brilliant.
It's using that PlayStation virtual reality headset. That's what makes you go blind.
But yeah. So there's always been problems with technology. I don't even know where we got to with VR. But then I've heard some stories about the Vive, which really does interest me, especially with... We were making fun of them about their controller setup, weren't we? Where it's like two little circle things, where you hold them like that. And a lot of people who have actually demoed the Vive the moment... you can't see me, can you?
No.
It's two... I don't know how to explain it. It's like
nunchucks?
Two nunchucks, yeah.
On the Wii.
I get what you mean now. Yeah, but a lot of us were making fun saying, oh, this isn't going to work. Why would you need to do that? And then people who have actually demoed the Vive at PAX, they've said, this makes perfect sense. One thing with VR that a lot of people find weird is when you reach out for something that's in the real world, you're feeling around for it, aren't you? You would expect to feel around for it because you're pretty much blind in front of you.
Yeah.
Well, with the Vive, you don't have that problem. You can just reach out and grab it because you can sort of see the image in your VR headset. It's not a camera. It's actual what's in the game. So it reacts to the actual controller and has the controller there. Now... that's what I want to see with VR. And I agree. It doesn't work where you're still sat down. You haven't got the immersion you want with a VR headset. Unless you're playing a game where you are
just
actually
sat
down.
It's limited to first-person games. Like, it ain't going to work on any other game but a first-person game.
Most first-person, not all. So
That's one limitation already. Mm-hmm. And then what you got? Anything that's got fast reaction times, like Call of Duty or something like that, that ain't gonna work. Stuff like that, you know. It's only gonna be able to have, you know. That's why horror's the only one that really appropriate, because on them ones, all you do is just run or don't turn your flashlight on.
Well, we'll see more about. We'll talk a little bit more about VR next week, anyway, because like I said, I'm hopefully gonna have a go of the Vive, and I'll have another go of the Oculus, and hopefully we'll have God back as well. So
who is this doc? I have not seen him for a long, long time.
He's your other half of your team, hey?
I know. He's not been around for a long time.
He's been busy.
I forgot what he looks like and what he sounds like and what he tastes like.
He tastes like chicken.
Yes, I did just take it into a very weird place.
Yeah, let's move on to something else. Retailers have leaked that Bioshock collection for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One.
Oh, that's interesting. I'll be happy with that.
Yeah, so a collection of the games in the Bioshock series might be coming to...
There's only three?
Yeah, I know. Might be coming to the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One, according to a listing from a South African retailer.
Plus DLC, I bet.
The page, which has since been removed but is accessible via Google Cache... reveals a release date of November 27th for the Bioshock collection. So I'm going to guess it should be all free games.
It's just ports.
It's just ports
of the games that like brought over to next gen console, and all they've done is just upscale the resolution. Then I'm not going to be that impressed.
Well, how this is 2K here, who's going to be setting this collection thing up? So do you think it's going to just be a port, going to be ports, or
just a little touch up on I'm not saying like a full remastered remake or something like that.
Just a little touch up.
Tweaks, because I don't know. When you look at old Bioshock 1, it does look bloody ugly in some areas. You know, when it comes to the bodies and stuff like that. I mean, I know the fish. Landscape and stuff like that. The city looks like nice and that, but when you're in combat and you're seeing all the splices and stuff, they don't look bloody.
I'm looking forward to it still, because okay, I'm not a fan of Bioshock 2. I am a fan of the first one. I am a fan of Infinite. Is it Infinite?
Yeah.
Thanks. I am a fan of both those two. But then, even when this comes out, I don't.
Did you try the DLC for Bioshock 2?
No, I didn't try the DLC.
That's better than the actual game itself.
That's bad if the DLC is better than the actual game. No,
the DLC was really good. The Bioshock 2 was, I felt, was okay, but really short and not very challenging at all.
That's the one with the big sisters in it.
Yeah, I didn't find it challenging at all in the slightest, even on the hard mode.
Well, how much do you think this will come out for?
£30. Not three games, I'm going to say 40.
You say 40. And do you think it's a good idea bring it out November the 27th?
No.
Best.
Yeah, it's kind of in competition right now, isn't it? It should have been like something like a midsummer release, shouldn't it?
Things
are a bit boring right now. We haven't got many releases recently.
Yeah, I think
that would have been just right.
I think the ports and the HD editions of games should be exclusively to the summer.
Yeah.
Because nobody wants to play an old game when all these new games are coming out. I mean, by then, I'll probably play a lot of Fallout 4. So, this game's not even going to get a sniff then.
You have to wait 6 months until I'm finished with Fallout 4.
Yeah. And then it's got a hope that nothing else takes my attention.
And then DLC of Fallout 4 comes out, and you're like, well, guess you're going to have to wait a year.
I mean, at the moment, I'm loving MGS.
I already see how Cajr's schedule is set for at least the next 7 months.
He's got it all on his calendar.
He's got MGS all the way up to when Fallout 4 comes out, and then he's got Fallout 4 all the way up to when The Division comes out.
I've got a few beats to play in the meantime as well.
Exactly. So we've got Siege, which is...
Yeah, I've got guaranteed my Siege one, but I've also applied to get into the Need for Speed one. Mm.
I'm still not looking forward to seeing what's happening. Hopefully I'm going to have a go of most of the games that are going to be at EGX, which are most of the games that are going to be coming out for Christmas, which is nice. Hopefully we'll get a bit more information about that next week as well.
Got any games there that you excited to play the most?
I'm excited to play, well, the VR headsets, of course.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to Guitar Hero and Rock Band a little bit. I've heard Fallout 4's there as well. So I might have a go of that. Mm-hmm. And Siege. just to upset Cajr.
I still find it really weird that Fallout 4's coming out.
I do too. It is definitely going to be that game that I hope it's a huge success.
Can't not be.
It can not be a huge.
The only way it can fail.
Worst case scenario, it don't live up to obviously expectations, but I don't think it's like hits the same mark as Fallout 3 in New Vegas does. The same atmosphere and stuff like that. That's the only thing that can feel like it could.
Or the game's broken.
Yeah. Well,
that's a given to me. I think we're going to come across a lot of bugs. It's a Bethesda game that's free roam. We're going to
I mean, I think the biggest thing on New Vegas was the save data getting corrupted.
Yeah.
That was the one of the big ones on bugs on New Vegas.
I think the one thing that worries me about Fallout 4 still is that we've not really seen much about the actual story itself. We've seen...
They're not going to give it away, are they?
Yeah, they're not going to give it away, but yeah, but, at the same
but the
time...
Thing, the, thing is, is, the thing is, the story's never been a big part of Fallout. It's all about the exploration.
I don't know.
Skyrim. It's not a... This game...
That's what worries me a little bit. When you say it's like Skyrim. Now, I wasn't a fan of Skyrim.
Yeah, but Fallout was... You know, it's vice versa, isn't it? Fallout is like Skyrim, and Skyrim is like Fallout. It's always been like that.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that it's not about the story, because there's so much more content than the story. That's the story's not important. You don't even have to touch the story.
It's Fallout 3 and the Vegas story ain't that great anyway, so...
Yeah.
Well, I'm not expecting anything that front. I think like characters and stuff like that, and like, you know, the little quests and little, you know, background information and lore and stuff like that is fantastic. Mm. Fallout.
And also, you've got this new one, Build Your Own Settlement.
That's what bugs me about it. I'm hoping they don't expect you too much for this Build Your Own Settlement stuff. Because, no offense, that sounds like something that should be on an iOS game. It's just the title alone, Build Your Own Settlement. It's Sims 4.
Yeah, you've got Fallout Shelter.
It's Sims 4 in a post-apocalyptic landscape.
Doc would love that bit.
Oh no, I've just ruined what Fallout 4 is. It's just The Sims.
it's just tricked it into Doc's life.
But, he's going to hear that and he's going to look at it and think, damn you, GD, why?
But like I say,
they even speak good language.
Games like that now, they add so much other than the main quest. I mean, Skyrim, I can remember just not touching the main quest for hours. Before, you know what, I better get on with the main quest.
Oh, I'm a bit overpowered for the story now, aren't I?
Well, you know what? One mod that I loved on Skyrim when I played it, like PC,
was a mod that
you could just sort of like hide the main story. So, like, you start off completely, your character's randomized on what he is like, and you start in a random town. So, you sort of like build up your own story of the character.
Yeah.
You feel like your own instead of just picking up from where he left off. I find that really fun.
Yeah, because there's so much content in them games. There's this story. You've got this quest, you've got this place to find, you've got these weapons, you've got this base, whatever. It's like, I want to go and do all that.
Well, I think all I need to do is have a go of it. I think that's what with my worry is I just need to have a go of it, see how I go with it, and then I'll be happy or sad.
Also, the problem with them kind of games is they can be quite difficult to get into.
That's it, yes.
Because you've got to build up your arsenal of what you're thinking, get your perks and all that shit. And then it's like, now I feel like I'm ready sometimes. It's like, you want to get... I mean, I remember, I think it was New Vegas, I wanted to get certain perks before I got to certain points. Like, I remember, I think one of them was getting to New Vegas itself, and I wanted to get it using the science method. Basically, you bleed out a lot of quarter, but I think you have to get your science stat up to about level about 60, 70.
Yeah.
And that meant being outside of New Vegas, where you had no house, or you had to carry everything you had, and then when you run outside, it's like,
oh,
God,
no. Oh no. hi, Jimmy.
But Jimmy, you've been so quiet in this
Hello,
podcast.
Man. You've been so quiet. You've been
putting that same face this whole time.
This is paedophile face.
It's no. Me. I know it's you. Where the hell have you been?
Like I said, there's so much content in these games. And like I said, they can be a steep climb to get into. It's like, I'm dragging this out. I feel like I'm just grinding. And then once it kicks in, it's like, once you've got that base or whatever.
The thing is, that's the thing that I'm worried about, especially what time of the year it's coming out, where Okay, I agree. Fallout 4 is going to be a huge seller. No doubt about that. A lot of people are going to end up buying this game. But it's like any other game that's coming out at the end of the year. You've got that problem where you've got all these games coming out that are also trying to grab your attention at the same time. And they're not small titles that are trying to grab your attention, are they? You've got Halo, and you've got... Forza 6 has just come out, hasn't it?
Yes. I'm currently playing that as of this moment.
Exactly. But you know, you understand what I'm coming from where Fallout 4... I guess it's going to be a great game, and I know it's going to be a great game, and it is going to be huge, but that is what I'm fearing about it, is because it's going to be huge, that people will not have that time to play that game. It's like with me, and I do want to play Metal Gear Solid 5.
But it's a brilliant game.
It's a brilliant game, I agree, but it's too big a game when I've got other games to play. And it doesn't help at the set also where you've got placed it. We're now in a generation where we get games given to us on a monthly basis for free, as long as you've got to be subscribed to play online. We're given games that we play. Look at PlayStation and look at Xbox. We get two games a month from both of them now. And with Xbox as well, they've got the backwards compatibility coming in November. That's the other thing that fears. We've got that coming. Yeah, well, I know. Don't. you'll be glad if there was a subscription service on Nintendo that gave you a free game a month. You would take it. Well, unfortunately, they'll be running out of games before the end of the year.
No, I would not do a subscription service on Nintendo. It's one of the fucking good points of Nintendo.
There's good points in Nintendo.
What? It's one of the few good things about Nintendo. They're not charging you for fucking everything.
Yet. Don't forget you've got a new president, mate.
You've got this mysterious NX. Who knows what that is?
Which is going to have a Pikmin game on it.
Yes. Sold.
Sold. I don't know. Like I said, that's the thing that worries me, where we are in a generation where we have got a ton of games coming out for us, where indie games are more popular as well as AAA titles. And Fallout 3 and Skyrim was such a huge success because you didn't have that much competition as you have nowadays to keep your attention in gaming. So that's the one thing I worry about Fallout 4. For example, look at The Witcher 3, which came out this year. People lost their attention of that very quickly.
Yeah, I get what you're saying, but I think...
And I think Metal Gear Solid 5, no offence, is doing great at the moment. I give it a couple of more weeks, and when the games start coming out, a lot of people will lose their attention with that.
Ah, but that's where they've got an ace in the hole, Metal Gear Solid.
Is it the online?
I've been told there's a video of the online, and it looks absolutely brilliant.
Why does this sound very familiar to another
GTA.
Game? Yeah.
So it's got that something that possibly might keep it going.
But then
might
that's be. Something Fallout 4 will not have.
But
they will not
Fallout,
have the
Fallout,
online.
But Fallout 4 has got, doesn't need the online. They've always been...
Nah, it's not built for online. Like,
the game's the story and all that, it's not built.
It's supposed to be about isolation and just wandering on your own.
Mm.
Yeah. Like I said, we've just got to see what happens with Fallout 4 and how long it takes for them to last around. I don't know. I'm more worried. It's not that I don't think... I think it's going to be a brilliant game. I think it's going to be a great game.
Stop worrying.
But that's the thing. I'm worried about it being a big game. That's it.
You've got... What other big games have you got coming out this year?
Halo 5.
Halo 5, right. So, after the buckle which was the friggin' Master Chief Collection, are you expecting the online to be any better this time?
I'm just hoping it works.
You're a dreamer. Stop dreaming too big.
Sorry.
Settle down.
That's the impossible lot. But so you've got that. What else have you got to come out that you want to play? You personally?
Siege, which comes out on the 1st of December.
Alright, so that's a shooting game, so that won't last long. Sorry, but shooters the 10 to a penny.
I know. I can't think off the top of my head without looking at the actual list.
Tomb Raider,
yeah, good point. That's definitely a game. Which, so guess what? It comes out a couple of days after Fallout 4 comes out.
Yeah, but that, to be honest, will that not be a game you'll play online now and then? You won't really play the, you'll play the campaign through maybe?
Oh, no, I will play through the campaign. I played through the campaign.
Right, so yeah, once you've played it, and then you're not going to hammer it, it's not going to be like you're going to be playing it every day for weeks on end, are you?
No.
So the Fallout has got that little area it can fill of, oh, I'm going to do some exploring, so I'm going to go in this direction.
The thing is, this is, we think they're going to have that.
It's a bloody free roaming game.
It's a free roaming game, but there's many free roaming games out there which is still, yeah. If I want to play a free roaming game, guess what? I would go with GTA Online at the moment.
Yeah, but you've played that to death.
I haven't, by the looks of things, because they still give us stuff.
Yes.
How, no, 1 minute. Do you not want to play the new stuff that has come out on GTA Online?
I think I prefer Fallout, like the Fallout world to the Grand Theft Auto world.
Yeah, there'll be a lot more in the Fallout world. There'll be a lot more quirks to it. It won't be just a lot of people killing each other. You'll have all the Deathstalkers and the feral ghouls.
Wait, I thought it was Deathclaws.
What am I thinking of?
Deathstalkers
a game. I think Nightstalkers, that's
Super
the one.
Mutants, you got the Feral Ghouls, you got the Enclave, you got Brother of Steel. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, you've got that much exploration you can do.
You got, you know, like, you can side with some people and you can go against another.
Look, either way, we've just got to see what happens with this.
GTA, back to what you said. GTA, what have you got? What you've got? Oh, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go to this point. I'm going to kill anybody that's in my path. Right. I'll do it same again tomorrow.
I think it brings out my dark side, GTA. Remember that. I can do many evil things with that game. I think I even had a point where I had stood on top of a building just sniping people. For the hell of it, until Cad showed up and sniped me.
Can yes. you cow tip two-headed cows?
Quick question, why would I want to?
Why wouldn't you?
I think this is a perfect time to end that conversation. So, we are getting close to the end of the podcast again.
That means we've got another half an hour.
Yeah, exactly. So let's do a few quick updates, starting with... Oh, fuck.
What? Go on.
Let's start with some Fallout 4 sort of news.
Yeah, we need to talk about Fallout 4, we do.
Real-life dog meat from Fallout 4 dares you not to fall in love.
I'll try.
Yeah, Fallout 4's canine companion takes a spotlight in the video released today by the game's developer, Bethesda. The model for the dog for Dogmeat, one of 12 characters who can accompany your player in the game, is a German Shepherd owned by Bethesda's Joel Burgess. So they've actually got a video of the dog who did the motion capture for Dogmeat in this video.
That's a video I'm not going to watch.
Yep.
The Legend of Zelda Hyrule Warriors port limits 3D mode on the new 3DS. What's the point?
Sorry, when it on the 3DS, but new 3DS, it's okay.
Yeah.
That's what it is, yeah. Yeah, because processing, isn't it? Because the new 3DS has a bigger processor.
So it can't
handle the 3D, so it's just a way of... I'd rather have that than it being only available for the new 3DS.
Okay.
GD.
I'm confused. Yeah. Prison Architect is going to believe in early access and it will get a full release next month. I did not know that it was still in early access.
Me neither.
No. Life is Strange, fifth and final episode is coming out next month. It'll be out on October the 20th. So, I haven't even finished the first episode of that. So, I might have a go of it again.
I don't even know what the hell it is.
It's the one with the girl and the pictures. Where you can go back.
That narrows it down.
Yeah, which you can rewind time. The nope. Square Enix game.
Nope, yep, still not ringing any bells.
Okay, fair enough. Oh, have you heard about the women's international teams in FIFA 16, where the NCAA has told FIFA that they can't have certain people in their game because it affects their non-revenue class? Because they're not classed as professional because they are either going to be or are in university. And it doesn't make the NCAA happy where they're not going to be making any money from them themselves.
Right, but isn't that up to the person whoever owns the rights of the...
Not in America by the looks of things.
So the women's national football team, there's certain players who don't have the right to be in there because they don't own their own image. So
yes, basically. Pretty much, yeah.
So, that's my shit.
Yeah, it's like with... You know, like college American football and college basketball, where they're not allowed to be put in games unless it's specifically said that the NCAA gets money from it.
Hmm.
It's the same with this as well. So I think it's 16 women players who have not been put in the game, where none of them are the English team, which no shock there. But it's like from Canada, Mexico, US, of course.
Basically North America.
North and South America, yeah. So that's sad.
So if I were them women, I'd be saying, look, this is probably my one and only chance to get into this thing.
Yeah, but then they can just turn around and say, well, then you're not allowed in university. It's America. That's all I've got to say
America
about that.
Dicks. Sorry if anyone's American in the chat, but...
Americans College Association is a... basically dicks, yeah.
I mean, these women, they were put in the game primarily for the success of the Women's World Cup. Unfortunately, that's the top and bottom of it. They went for the success of that. The odds are they might not have got in the game. Agreed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, now, it's something that's celebrating these women for their achievements, and then they say, you know what, you can't be in it now because we own the rights of your face and your name.
I just read chat about the GTA and, yeah, okay, but yeah, I do feel it's stupid with this where they do not allow it, but then again, this is just how American law, how their rules work out there. It's stupid, it's capitalism, it's all crap.
I mean, it's everyone's got to get their slice of the pie,
exactly.
Sort of speak.
Yeah, and unfortunately, I don't know. We can't complain. Lucky for us, we're in a country where we haven't got our universities that do stupid things like this, because they realise that they get more money if it's someone popular. Yeah, they get more money from the students. Yeah, actually, I think they charge more in America.
Much.
Yeah,
I think America's got a lot worse.
Yeah. The Xbox One Elite controller gets a release date of October the 27th. That's the $150 controller.
Something I won't be buying.
Of course, no one will be. No, someone will be, unfortunately.
It'll probably end up being something they throw in as a bundle with the Xbox. It'll be, instead
well,
of
they've,
having
already, they've already said that they have got a bundle.
Yeah, but that's all it'll end up being. It'll just be, right, you want the Xbox Elite, you get the Elite controller with it.
Shimmy, stop being... machoist, whatever the word is. Stop being a dick.
That's shimmy.
Stop being
though,
a
that,
dog
that's
meat.
That's shimmy. I know.
Stop being a dog meat.
Stop being a dog meat, mate. Amazon doubling down on gaming with new Fire TV developing PC title. I wonder where they got this idea from. This is now going to be gaming on their Fire TV. Oh, it's not like Apple already said that they were doing that, and then there was Zuya. I don't understand where this idea is coming from. And Minecraft Pocket Edition is basically going to be mobile games on this Fire TV again.
Yeah.
What is the point?
TVs that got Minecraft before Wii U.
You're going to get you're going to get it sooner rather than later as a Telltale game.
Yeah, I'm not going to buy it on Wii U on PC because I'll probably get it cheaper.
Damn it. You can try out Dark Souls 3 with network stress test.
Dark Souls 3.
Yeah, new Dark Souls 3. It's just as hard.
Yay, I get Dark Souls 3.
Dark Souls 3.
Yeah, try again, GD.
Yeah, Dark Souls. You can try out a Dark Souls 3 with network test stress test beta. Bandai Namco is going to be taking sign-ups for upcoming server tests for Dark Souls 3. Fans of the series can register online for the PlayStation 4 beta, which will run sometime in mid-October, for a chance to download the version of the game to test.
Cool.
Doing so will help the game's developer from software determine what you expect from a beta. It's determine if it can how many servers, blah blah blah.
Yeah,
if
it can handle it.
Exactly. So I find it weird, especially with a game like Dark Souls 3, to do this. I'd expect it with, what's it called? Call of Duty, maybe Fallout 4. But, yeah. Let's see how that goes. I might try and sign up for it. Rocket League. The next Rocket League DLC is called Revenge of the Battle Cars. Called Revenge of Battle Cars, inspired by the original title, Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Powered Battle Cars. The pack will include two classic cars, Scarab and Zippy. The download is going to be coming out in October to PC as well as the PlayStation 4, and will also include two new boost effects, 12 car decals, 4 toppers, and 3 new paint finishes. So it's what's it called? A cosmetic DLC. Yeah. But you get 2 new cars at least. It depends on how much it's going to cost with me.
I don't know if it's.
It's cosmetic. It's not worth it.
Yeah. Why not give us like a new mod or make it so we have guns on top of our car so we can shoot each other?
Is the mode that we've already got not good enough for you, mate? I'm still enjoying the what's it called? Just playing normal football on that game.
Yeah, but it's another mode. It's not if you get bored of one mode, you can play a second one.
Mm. Oh, Marty number 9. We already know that the actual game's been delayed, but now the demo has also been delayed.
What about the TV show?
Oh God,
the other 5 things he's doing.
How is this gone? So it was everyone was excited, thinking this is going to be a new revolution on Kickstarter, and then they just completely mess it up by being too greedy.
Yeah. Isn't Shenmue 3 wanting more money?
Oh yeah. No, I love how they explain this with Shenmue 3. They're basically going to be pulling it back up on Kickstarter for those people who were too lazy to back it last time.
That's not too bad. It's just missing out because. Yeah, missing out on the perks for PayPal. It's for the people that pledged, but once the deadline hit, their processes failed.
Right.
Their transactions failed, so it's just a chance to get your fin back. That's all it is. Most Kickstarters do that.
Yeah, but it's kind of ironic that it's another 30 days of it.
Yeah, 30 days is a bit taking the mick, really. Yeah. It should be like a couple of weeks at least, at the most.
A couple of weeks, like 4.
Yeah.
That's only 28 days. It's not
quite
30.
Oh my god, it's not 30. I don't know. I don't understand the Shenmue 3 thing. We've already spoken about.
Oh, it's loads of fans who want it. Mm. I'm not one of them, so.
I'm not either. I've not played any of the other two, so.
Well, yeah, not many people.
I didn't even know it existed until it all kicked off on
Kickstarter. Well, it's a Dreamcast game, so I don't think many people have.
Nintendo has delayed Star Fox Zero to 2016. It's probably going to come out on the NX at this rate.
If it does, fucking hell. Oh, we've got to help it.
Oh, if that's NX graphics. Yeah, so how do you feel about that?
I don't think I'm sorry about it going to NX. You can see from myself it's got Wii U written all over it, unfortunately. Yeah. Because that gamepad. That's fucking ruined that.
Metal Gear Solid 5 DLC is going to be including horse armor and more.
Yay, it's like Oblivion all over again with its gold armor.
The Uncharted 4 A Thief's End multiplayer beta starts on December the 4th through to December the 13th. There's going to be a Phoenix Wright anime coming in April 2016.
What?
I'm looking forward to that. As much as you...
Yeah, sounds good. For some reason, like, when you said it out loud, I thought of it as... For some reason, it went from my head as Marcus Phoenix anime. I was like, huh? The guy from Gears of War. Huh?
Shimmy.
What's he done now?
Not Shimmy, sorry. I'm thinking... I'm getting tired now because I'm just looking. I just looked down and all I can see in chat boxes Shimmy's things from earlier.
Yeah.
And so I had Shimmy in my head.
Maybe this is the last one then. Braid follow up. The Witness is finally going to be arriving on the PS4 and PC in January. I think that was demoed when the PS4 was announced, where it's got the first person view of the puzzles and stuff like that. So yeah. So, moving on.
Sorry. Have you seen the live action movie of Phoenix Wright?
I haven't yet.
Oh, it's amazing.
Is it actually good, or is it really bad? Good. Or
it's fucking good. It's like everything's perfect.
I might watch that. I'm gonna probably find it then later. It can't be any worse than the Attack on Titan one, I'm guessing.
No, because it's over the top, it's wacky, just like, you know, the show itself. Everyone looks like their actual counterpart if you're in life.
Just going to have a look the next little bit. Before we move on to the last two bits, let's do the have you got any plans this week type of it. So, Billy, any game nights planned? Any streams planned?
I'm going to have a break from streaming this weekend.
Yeah, what happened to the Mega Drive? You started it and then you stopped it, didn't you?
Yeah, I got a game over.
I died. Wow.
Yeah, I died in Sonic again. I actually got a game over in a Sonic game.
You do know that you can continue going, right?
No, it just went, no, fuck
game
you.
Game over, fuck you, that's screen. It, we're not doing this anymore, get lost.
Well, I was just like, I lost all motivation because that was like, fuck you, I just lost 12 lives in one sitting.
Well, I know that your Sonic 2 video is going to be coming out on Wednesday anyway on the Crave Your Game YouTube channel. With an awesome thumbnail, in my opinion.
Yes, I love it.
I loved it too. It was fun to make. So, Cajr, what about you, mate? Have you got any game nights planned, any streams planned?
First of all, have we anything planned for CTG this week? That'll be a no, because you're away.
I'm not here,
I can't think of anything else that anyone else has planned. If I can get the time, I'm working stupid hours at the moment at work, so my time's very limited. But if I do, it'll possibly be my Mass Effect event, finally. I keep saying every damn week.
Yeah.
Blame MGS5 at the moment. But I can't think of anything other than that.
So, by the way, you can find both of these if they all do change their mind about streaming. You can find it twitch.tv/ for Cajr, it's CAJR87. For Billy, Billy Boomers. It's Bead. Same with their Twitter handles, just add the at the beginning. So, for me, like I said, I'm not going to be here, unfortunately, but if you are following me on Twitter, either on the @CraveYourGame or @GDW2007, I will be using Periscope while I'm in Birmingham for EGX. So, expect some pictures and stuff like that showing up on the Twitter, on my Twitter feed. I think we might play a little bit of Wordsput tonight if you're up for it, Billy.
A short one, maybe.
A short one, yeah.
Got work in the morning.
Good point. We'll probably have a short one or two games, depends on how we feel about it. For this week on the YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/CraveYourGames, today we had the first part of Wordsput come out, also titled as Billy Loves Long.
There's context in the video.
There's context in the video, yeah. On Tuesday, we have Chapter 3 of Cajr's Until Dawn playthrough. And when on Wednesday, we have, like we said, Billy playing Sonic. On Thursday, we have the second part of mine and Doc's playthrough on Rocket League. And then on Friday, we've got the podcast itself. So, yeah, I think that's all I can think of. I'm not streaming this week, unfortunately, because I'm not here half the week.
Oh, well, 1 week's off. It's not too bad. And you give us plenty of information.
Information.
Yeah, so...
So let's do the top five games. Number five, down three places, is Mad Max. At number four, down three places, is Metal Gear Solid 4, The Phantom Pain. New at number three is... Sorry?
Is it Metal Gear Solid 4, The Phantom Pain?
Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain.
There you go.
Thank you. New at number three is Pro Evolution Soccer 2016. New at number two is Forza Motorsport 6. And new at number one is Destiny The Taken King, which has now outsold the original Destiny.
Don't know why.
Now, a lot of people are saying this is actually a really good game now. It's taken them a year to make a good game. Well done, Bungie. For game releases, starting... From Thursday, the 24th of September, FIFA 16 comes out on the 360, PS3, Xbox One, PS4, and PC. And City Skylines After Dark comes out on PC as digital only. On Friday, the 25th of September, we have Skylanders Superchargers coming out on the Wii, 360, PS3, Wii U, Xbox One, PS4, 3DS, and iPad.
Oh, iPad. That's
and iPad, yeah, that's different. Saint Seiya Soldier's Soul comes out on the PS3 and PS4. X-Blaze Code Embryo comes out on the PS3 and PS Vita, which I swear I say this every week. Grand Age Medieval comes out on the PC, and we have a bunch of amiibos coming out again. We have, we've got Mr. Game & Watch, Rob, Duck Hunt Duo, the Brawler, Mii Gunner...
Talk about the beat list of fucking amiibos, or...
The Mii Gunner, the Mii Brawler, and the Mii Sword Fighter.
Wow.
So what's the big one?
I would say for this week, the big one is probably FIFA 16.
No, I meant in the Amiibos. What's the one that everyone's going to be clambering for?
What, out of these ones?
Yeah. Mr.
Game & Watch, maybe.
I would say Mr. Game & Watch.
Because if Mr. Game & Watch, you can change it around.
No, it's going to be the Mii Sword Fighter. Everyone loves the Mii Sword Fighter.
It's not customizable.
What do you think it's going to do if you pull it on your Wii U, vibrates and turns into your Mii?
No, it's just put little wigs on it and little clothes, like a little doll.
I think that is the perfect time to say thank you for joining us on the podcast for this week. We will be back on normal schedule on Wednesday. Hopefully we've got more people. Hopefully, but thank you for joining me again, Billy. Thank you for joining me, Cajr. For the people who are watching this on YouTube and the audio version of the podcast, we have a little surprise for you at the end of the podcast, where me and Cajr did a few questions and answers after our WWE prediction last week. So there you go. I hope you guys enjoy that. And until then, thank you and goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hopefully all these will be pieced together for tomorrow that you can see on www.youtube.com/craveyourgames. Just Susie, to answer your question... who do we think will be champs after Night of Champions? Cajr, do you want to go first?
Charlotte, Dudley's, Cena, Ryback, Sting.
I think Charlotte, Dudley's, Kevin Owens, John Cena and Sting as well. I think we both think that Seth Rollins are going to lose his titles because it might make a more interesting story. I've got a feeling Seth Rollins is not going to be walking away with both titles, at least. He's going to lose one of them.
He's definitely going to lose one. I think he'll definitely lose the world.
Yeah.
Because of...
Sting.
No, because it's Sting. Because they're teasing him coming away from the Authority.
Rollins can't lose both of them, I think. Yeah, he can. He's in two separate matches at Night of Champions.
Well,
it is possible for him to lose both of them.
But well, to answer his question, I think Cena was better as the US champ because the open challenge, he was fighting anybody and everybody, and some of the matches he had were awesome. I mean, the two Cesaro matches, Sami Zayn,
the Kevin Owens
Neville.
Match. Can't forget the Kevin Owens.
Well, they were pay-per-views. I'm thinking these were just on Raw.
Yeah.
To me, going to Seth Rollins at the moment, it will feel like a backward step.
Yeah, it feels weird that he owns both championships at the moment.
So that's why I think he's going to lose the US and the world. I think it's purely to set up the Authority basically abandoning Seth Rollins.
Yeah. I think that
because it was all teased a few weeks ago when Sting said Seth Rollins is not the legend Triple H is.
Yeah.
And Stephanie agreed with Sting, and the seeds have been planted.
I think the seeds have been planted quite a while because there has been quite often where I think with the Brock Lesnar match, I think that was where it started a little bit, where Triple H pretty much announced that his next opponent at Battlegrounds will be Brock Lesnar. And you don't think that you're the poster boy. We want you to have the title. Here is basically a wall of meat. He's going to be coming running at you in a very, very fast. You're going to be flattened, I'm going to be honest with you.
There was a subtle one on Raw just gone as well, where at the end of Seth Rollins' match, and he was rolling out the ring and he was struggling to stand up, Triple H went over and he literally dragged him up.
Yeah.
As if to say, just get up, we're not happy with you, sort of thing. I mean, it's only a subtle thing. It's only a little... It's like blink, you'll miss it, Mom. But
the thing is, it's not just this past... Building up to Night of Champions as well has... there has been... It's not just Sting who's been planting these little seeds in. It's also
James
John,
as well.
And John Cena. When John Cena said... when the match was announced that he will be facing John Cena for the US Championship at Night of Champions as well, he pretty much said, look, the Authority is not on your side. They are on your side at the moment because it's best for business. But if there's another transaction that is best for business, like, for example, the US Championship being put on the line at Night of Champions, then they will go against you.
At that moment, it backed Stephanie into a corner. Because he said...
It wasn't much of a corner, though, was it?
But no, he basically said, Stephanie, you said that every title will be defended and I have a rematch clause.
Yeah.
So basically backed Stephanie into a corner. And obviously Seth Rollins didn't like it.
But either way, I've got a feeling sooner rather than later, Seth Rollins will realise. It'll be in the story as well. That the Authority is not on his side.
Triple H ends up costing him the title.
That's another question. Does Sheamus cash in his Money in the Bank at Night of Champions? I don't think he will.
Hopefully not. Now, we said this later in the video, but I'll say it again because obviously you...
We said it on... was it Sunday? It was Sunday. Yeah.
Sunday, yeah. No, it's just... I think Sting's going to win it. I hope that they give him at least one Raw or maybe in a full month with the title. And I've actually been thinking of this. Seth Rollins gets his rematch clause at Hell in a Cell, and that could be where Sheamus cashes in to stop Seth winning it back.
It would be quite ironic, though. What's it called? It's going to be a match of Sting versus Seth Rollins, and then Seth Rollins gets screwed over because of the Money in the Bank. That'd be awesome. I'm just going to point that. That's how we did it at WrestleMania, which I think that is one of the best things WWE, in my opinion, have done in a while. Because how many times have in the what's it called? The career mode on WWE games, when you have got the Money in the Bank, how many people have actually cashed it in at WrestleMania? Because it's supposed to be, that is the biggest night in WWE, isn't it? So why not get the title on the biggest night in WWE? You're going to be more known for cashing it in than say cashing it in at Raw.
Yeah,
unless you're Edge, that's different. That's Edge.
No, like I say, my big hope is they don't. Well, my biggest fear is that they take it off Sting straight to it, because then it kind of cheapens the fact he has been WWE World Champion.
Yeah,
because it'll have been for a matter of minutes.
Whereas he doesn't
get that chance to go into the crowd as the go to Raw as champion. He don't get a chance to say, I won the title. I am the champion.
Yeah. Will Undertaker return to WWE ring never again? No, I think he will return because they've left it too much on a cliffhanger with the Brock Lesnar. But it depends on his health. Because you told me that he fainted, he collapsed again after SummerSlam, which I didn't know about, to be honest.
There is videos
you haven't seen
online of that moment.
Yeah, so I think story-wise, yeah, he will return, but health-wise, probably not. I think he is more than likely going to be in the Hall of Fame next year, because it's not an if, it's a when for him. And I think it's about time for him to be. He hasn't got the streak anymore. And no offense, his match against Bray Wyatt was a bit weak for a WrestleMania match that had The Undertaker in it. I think it was because that feeling, will he lose in this match, kind of disappeared when he got beaten by Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, all that disappeared. Yeah, I agree with that.
So I think it is time for Undertaker to probably hang up his hat and just join the Hall of Fame, which is, it's sad, I'm a huge Undertaker fan, but yeah, I think it's time for him to call it a night. What about you? Do you think that's it for the Undertaker?
Me? Are you talking
you.
To chat?
No, I'm talking to you.
Oh, I thought you were talking to chat. I think he needs that retirement match. Not against Brock Lesnar. A match just to...
What about against the Wyatt's new strongman?
No. But I think he needs that one match against... I think a retirement match for me should be against somebody big part of your career.
That might be a good question, actually. This is to chat itself. Who do you think should face Undertaker in his last match? If there is going to be a last match, who would you want to see as his last match? I can't think, actually, because it's... I don't think there's anyone... Personally, I don't think there's anyone worthy to be at the moment.
Mick Foley. Out of the cell.
That'd be great.
No, that'd be crap. Because Mick Foley was never, the most in shape kind of guy.
No. But like I said,
especially with his age now.
Well, like with me, I said I don't think there's anyone who in the current roster who could really.
Well,
do
even
it.
If they bring somebody back for one last match themselves, I mean, it could be that they bring, say, Shawn Michaels.
What about Kane?
I'm just using him as an example. A retirement match should be either somebody who's you've been like fighting with or teaming with
a lot over ears,
or someone who has a ton of respect for them,
or somebody who was similar to him. I mean, he had Ric Flair, and he was very much against Shawn Michaels.
Which, yeah, you can agree. Even though Ric Flair seems to pop up every now and then, even though he's retired.
Yeah, but he doesn't wrestle.
Yeah. Just says, well, Sting maybe, or Michaels, or Triple H.
Triple H I could see, because they've outfought a lot. Yeah. I mean, I've said all along what my end of Attitude Era match should be. It should be the four cornerstones of the Attitude Era, which would be
The Rock,
Triple
Stone Cold,
H,
Triple
Stone
H,
Cold,
and
The Undertaker in a Fatal 4-Way match.
Yeah, I think that should be the retirement match. May have retired the retired the Attitude Era with the Undertaker.
Yeah, because most of the Attitude Era now are getting on. I mean, look, Undertaker's in his 50s, Rock's probably late 40s, Triple H probably in his 40s,
well,
Stone Cold's,
H,
I think, 50-ish.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
they haven't got many more matches in them.
No. Well, I don't think Stone Cold can technically wrestle anymore, can he?
I think he can,
but
I think it's a case he needs a third person. He needs somebody else there to... Because he'll only be able to do it in... bits and pieces. He won't be able to wrestle a full match one-on-one on his own.
Yeah, I don't think Michaels, now looking at this, I don't think Michaels should be it, because wanted the Undertaker who retired Michaels.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Sting, I can't see that being a good match.
Because it's not really, no offense to Sting, but it's, Sting and Undertaker haven't really clashed that much, did they?
Well, they've always said the character system. You've got the Dead Man and the Crow character. Yeah. You know, they're very similar, yeah. But you got to look at it this way: it's two people who are over 50,
yeah,
trying to wrestle a match in Texas heat.
Yeah, that's a good point.
It's not. I can't see it being a good match. I just don't know how it's going to be a good match.
Mm. We'll make this our last question because we've got to get ready for the podcast anyway. Who do you want to be in the Hall of Fame class of 2016? Well, Undertaker, of course, with me.
Undertaker or Sting would be the main one.
Yeah.
Who would
be your diva to go into the Hall of Fame?
My diva. Who's my diva?
Who was on about Mickey
the diva
James,
not
weren't
in
we?
It. Mickey James, possibly. Sable's are rumoured to be this year's.
Yeah.
I mean, the thing with Astrid Era, the women didn't really stand out.
Has Miss Elizabeth been put in yet?
Possibly, but I don't think so.
What about Miss Elizabeth?
Yeah, but what did she actually do for the wrestling of women?
Good point. She was a manager.
She was just the arm candy of Macho Man.
I would then say, yeah, I think Sable deserves to be in it because she was the one who she was what was the Attitude Era of the Divas. Maybe Santina. Do you remember Santina? What about Vicky Guerrero?
No, she didn't do much. I know she was an authority figure, but she just annoyed the fuck out of me.
Oh, excuse me.
What about Beth Phoenix?
Yeah, she did actually quite
a lot.
She'd
fit in now.
Yeah, there's a couple of rumours that she might be coming back as well, but yeah, I would, she's one of a when moments for the Hall of Fame as well, in my opinion, unless something tragic happens.
So... That's the Hall of Fame diva. Who's the next?
Tag team.
They seem to be putting a lot of 80s teams in.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, China. Oh. No, not China. For certain reasons why not
China.
China
won't get in it. Not a chance. If she didn't go into porn, she'd be in it.
Oh, yeah. The thing is, no offense, she did quite a lot for during the Attitude Era for women. But because of certain things that has happened since she's been... Was she left? Did she leave WWE or was she kicked out of the WWE?
Does it really matter?
Either way, she's done a lot of things behind the scenes that gives us reasons she'll never be. She probably will be one day, but not for a long time.
I'm trying to think of tag teams. I don't think the New Age Outlaws are getting it.
Aww.
Don't get me wrong, they were great, but you can't really... Can you actually remember a huge moment so that's involved in New Age Outlaws? But can you name one match with the New Age Outlaws in it?
Didn't they not long one won match the that tag stands team out. Championship long ago? I think it was last year or the year before.
Don't I can't. Get me wrong, they're great. Like I said, yeah. But I can't see.
That's good point. Is Billy Gunn already in the Hall of Fame? He's not.
I think he's a coach.
I've got a feeling he will be put in the Hall of Fame because he does a lot of for WWE behind the scenes as well. Like I said, he's a coach in at the Performance Center, and he was a coach during the Tough Enough stuff as well, wasn't he? So I expect him to be in it, but I don't expect him to be in it yet.
No, it's still a bit early. I think there's still a lot of people.
Yeah. Like I said, I think we've got to get through the 80s stuff at the moment. What about
Rock and
Sock?
Yeah, they're going back to 80. No, Mick Foley's already in, but obviously Edge and Christian as a team could get in. I mean, there's rumours Christian on his own could go in.
Yeah, I forgot about that, yeah. That might be a good idea.
Rick Flair's been entered twice, once as the Fourth Horseman.
And one of them as himself, while he was still a wrestler, I'd like to point out.
So the people can get inducted twice for separate reasons.
So yeah, I would say probably Edge and Christian, because they're not going to be wrestling anymore, are they? Because Edge is definitely not going to be wrestling anymore.
I think an outside chance of Hall of Fame status soon could, well, maybe not soon, but down the road sometime, could be a Hardcore Holly.
Well, he's done a lot, hasn't he?
Because he joined in the 1990s, I think it were, early 1990s, and in like 12 years, he went through numerous personas. Like when I think he started off with something called Sparkplug or something like that.
Yeah.
And then he turned to Hardcore. But the thing about him, in all that time, even if he never wasn't on television, he never actually got released.
No, he just changed his persona so many times that he thought he was a different person.
Kept changing his gimmick until he found something that worked for him, and yeah. It was Hardcore Holly.
Yeah.
So he's an outside shot. I think the main one could be either Undertaker or Sting, depending on who's got the more less time wrestling wise.
There's a couple that I think more than likely it'll be Undertaker. I've got a feeling is going to be the main one this year, because like I said, he's collapsed twice. He's collapsed in his last two matches. Not the last two matches. He collapsed with both matches against Brock Lesnar. So, no offense, I think it is time for him to, and the Hall of Fame, come on, he's got to be put in the Hall of Fame no matter what, because he has done a lot for WWE. He has been one of the faces of the WWE for how many decades now?
He actually controlled the locker room as well. He's like the man that
Everyone's got respect for him. And come on, look at him.
There was rumours that before Shawn Michaels due to fight Stone Cold, that he pinned Shawn Michaels up against the wall and told him to do what he had to do instead of trying to
screw it up.
Basically, play it straight and instead of trying to be cocky and try and be Shawn Michaels like you were back then, the cocky little bastard.
Well, they said that he showed his true persona when he was in his badass stage, wasn't it? That was the true Undertaker, with the bike. He hasn't got a bike actually. I think that's what Michelle McCool said. He hasn't actually got a bike, but there will probably be a bike there soon.
So yeah, I mean, there's lots of Hall of Famers ready to go. People, there's lots of future Hall of Famers who are ready to go in.
Batista, I don't think yet.
No, like I said, there's a lot who will go in. Who, it's too early for them. Batista, Jericho, Orton,
Christian,
Cena, Triple H, The Rock. Christian could get in because he's actually retired. I think he's... Because he's retired from wrestling fully.
Don't joke about Spike Dudley. Spike Dudley's an awesome guy. I wouldn't mind. I wouldn't be surprised if we see him show up again now that Dudley boys are back.
Actually, there could be an outside shout of Hall of Fame status, the Dudleys.
Yeah.
This year.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, oh, yeah, the Dudleys. But then again, I don't know. It's one of those things where it depends on how long they're going to be in the WWE, in the tag team division.
Not really, because they're nine-time.
Ten times, hopefully.
Tag team champs. 10 times over by something.
Yeah.
So they could be, like I say, you've got that many people ready to go in over years, just from the post Attitude Era. Like I say, you've got Cena, Orton, Batista getting there, Jericho getting there, Triple H will down the line.
Yeah.
Vince McMahon will end up in the Hall of Fame himself, even though it's his own company, because he was there at the thing. He was on TV all the time. The Rock will get in there when he decides he wants to retire fully.
Say your last bit, because like I said, we're going to be cutting this now anyway.
No, I'm pretty much done.
That's pretty much done. Virgil.
Was he Ted DiBiase's?
Yeah, he was
bodyguard,
Ted DiBiase's sidekick. Sorry,
I'll tell you another one who could be a really good shout for Hall of Fame status this year. Goldust.
Yes, Goldust. He's not. Yeah, he's been gone since losing to
Fastlane, weren't it?
He won at Fastlane
because he pinned Cody Rhodes, didn't he?
Oh, and then he got attacked afterwards. Yeah. Sorry. Stardust.
Well, Stardust. Yeah.
Whatever.
So he could be an outshow church. I mean, yeah, I can't think of many.
Owen Hart.
There's rumours that... Owen Hart, rumours of him possibly going in there.
There is a few people. Like I said, it's tough to predict at the moment with Hall of Fame because there is a lot of people who we are... It's not an if, it's a when moment with them. It just depends on... because there's so many people, huge. We're in an era where... we start to see a new generation come into the WWE. It's like, is it the second generation for the Flairs with Charlotte?
Yeah, but when they say second generation, it's the second of that family.
Yeah.
Second, you got his dad. Mm. Look at the Roman Reigns and Rock family. They've got that many people in the who
have
been in the WWE or are in the WWE. I mean, you've got currently in the WWE. Because you've got the Usos, Roman Reigns, and The Rock when he turns up.
More than likely, if you're Samoan, you're probably from one of those families. If you're a wrestler and you're Samoan, you're probably from one of those families. No offense, but it does seem that way nowadays, doesn't it?
I mean, he had Rikishi as well. He had The Rock's dad and his granddad. He got inducted last year,
So,
I mean, another two people who are due for will get Hall of Fame status who are currently on the current roster. Big Show and Kane.
Yeah.
As much as you might hate them as they are now.
No. I love them as they are now. They're great. Umaga.
Umaga, another one for thinking.
He was another great,
But we're all thinking WWE. You've got to remember, there were people in WCW who might get into Hall of Fame.
That's a good point. We've got to remember now, it's not the WWE Hall of Fame, it is pretty much the Wrestling Hall of Fame nowadays. This is what people...
It is WWE,
but WCW is pretty much...
their own. Another one who might get in eventually, Kurt Angle.
Oh, that'd be interesting.
Is Booker T been entered yet?
Yeah, he's already entered.
JBL?
Yeah, that's what we was on about that, weren't we? JBL being part of it. Yeah, as much as you hate to say it, Michael Cole more than likely will end up there as well. Yeah, as
purely
much as,
because of number of years.
I know you don't like him, but he's been there for a while. Does Big Show earn one more championship? Yeah.
No.
I think that's where we're going to leave it.
In New York. In, I keep forgetting what it's called, the area in New York.
Oh yeah, well they just
Times Square, that's it.
Well, they're just pelting poor Mewtwo with
That was a bit harsh. I'm looking at the Pokeball, give him a chance.
He was like, "Jeez, he's getting enough of me or what?"
You will die, Mewtwo. You will die. And it's like a whole crowd. That's one thing that they're expecting to have with this, where there'll be actual public events